When they came back to the Twin Cities, the victorious gold medal winners were feted in a long and lively parade. In Washington, they'd been invited to lunch at the White House. In New Hampshire, Coach Herb Brooks became an instant write-in candidate for president. You'd almost think that Herb Brooks had gotten all the adulation that one hockey coach could get, but there was more in store for him today at the governor's mansion. There, the hockey team was honored with all Minnesota's other Olympic athletes, but the hockey players were obviously special. A gold medal embedded in an ice-sculptured centerpiece, jokes about Brooks's prominence now as a political force, and from Governor Al Quie, an award for the man who may not have played the game, but certainly won over the audience.
Saw you out there in the White House. All the team was wearing a gold medal around his neck, and there wasn't any gold medal around your neck at all. I heard that the coach doesn't get a medal in this business, and I want to make a presentation of a medal to you.
It was a brass medal, a remake of Quie's inaugural Star of the North, but the governor's staff said it was buffed to a nearly golden shine. Brooks accepted, but he insisted that the people who deserved the honor had already received it, the players.
Sometimes coaches or people in management forget about the people that seem to get things done, and I'm just happy to receive this, and I'm going to take it home, and when I think of it, I'll think of the players, and I'll think of you, Mr. Quie. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Herb.
Kathy Douglas, Channel 5 Eyewitness News.